Hey, first period, it's Miss Mac. I'm here with your Mice and Men Chapter 1 recap. So I'm gonna go over all the answers from last week. I got my copies of the book here. I have two. And so if you wanna check your answers or know what happened, here you go. All right, so question number one, George keeps yelling at Lenny about what happened in Weed. And the question is, what do we know that's happened so far? And we get more information later. So Weed is a real town. It's up on the California-Oregon border, way up north. And Lenny, as we know, is almost like a little kid. He's definitely like mentally disabled. And he really likes to pet soft things, seeing things that are like silky or furry. And he sees this woman in a beautiful red dress and he goes up to pet her dress. Which, if you can imagine, if you were a woman, and we know Lenny's really tall and big, if you saw this big man trying to pet your dress, you would probably scream. So she screams, she freaks out, she thinks he's trying to attack her, and they have to go run and hide, because back then Lenny would probably get put in jail, who knows, and George is trying to protect him. So George is always like really scared that Lenny is going to get them in trouble. And this is good to know, because it almost like hints that the types of things Lenny does, even though he doesn't do it on purpose, he gets himself in trouble because he is like kind of like a child, and you have to almost treat him like that. So that's question number one, and we get more on that later. Question number two, what does George make Lenny promise to remember at the end of chapter one? A couple things. One, that he's not gonna say a word to the boss, that he's gonna let George do all the talking, because Lenny, just when he talks, he gets them in trouble. So he's like, George, let me do it, don't say anything. And then also to remember where they were camping. So they're out spending the night in the brush, and George tells Lenny, if you get in trouble, you come back here. And like, to me, this is here on purpose. So I'm already starting to think like later on in the book, Lenny is gonna do something, he's gonna get in trouble, and he's gonna have to come here and hide. So let's like pay attention to these hints, as Mice and Men has so much foreshadowing, and we can like make so many guesses about what's gonna happen later on. And that's part of your classwork this week. All right, what is George and Lenny's dream? Sure, to get their own farm and to raise pigs and alfalfa for the rabbits, and basically live their own life independently, not have to work for someone else, to live off the fat of the land. Just means to live off what you can farm yourself, to not be dependent on anyone else. So that's their American dream, is to just be those two with their own piece of land. And we'll see if they get there. All right, so why does George always get frustrated with Lenny? This was question number four. Lenny forgets everything. He's a great worker, he's really strong, but again, he can be a handful. He has to carry his work cards for him, he has to make sure he has food, and I'm sure George gets really frustrated with Lenny, who's like an adult. So you see him yell at Lenny a lot. And Lenny, we talked about what kind of character is he. Again, he's very, very tall and big, but like a gentle giant. He likes to pet soft things like the dead mice, which sometimes he kills because he pinches them. So some very strange things about Lenny, but he and George get along, which is why your last question, because they've known each other forever. George promised his Aunt Clara, Lenny's Aunt Clara, he'd take care of him. They've worked together. It's probably they're really lonely. When they talk about their dream, they say how lonely these guys are who work on ranches. So at least they have a buddy. And I think that even though George gets really frustrated and angry with Lenny, he would be really sad, lonely if he didn't have Lenny. So anyway, that's your recap for chapter one. Chapter two, they start working on the ranch and we meet a whole bunch of new characters. So check out the next slide, and I have a video on chapter two. Bye.